In this video, you will learn how to access a file in KNIME Analytics platform. Different file types, such as Excel files, CSV files, and other text-based files, all have dedicated reader nodes that shares a similar configuration window. With those nodes, you can access files both locally and from remote locations. Let's have a look. To start off, let's take a look at the Excel reader node. Its first configuration option is the input location, which defines the path to the file to read. You can find this setting with exactly the same interface in other reader nodes as well, for example the CSV reader and the PMML reader. In the Read From section, you select the file system type and, if it's required, the specifier. In the first drop-down menu, you have four options for the path type: local file system, mount point, relative to, and custom NIME URL. First, let's select the local file system. This type accesses a file based on its location on the local machine. You can write the path manually or click the Browse button. The file field then shows the path from the system root directory to the selected file. The whole path can vary depending on the operating system. Second, let's select the mount point option. This type accesses a file in the Space Explorer using a path that starts with the name of the mount point. You select the name of the mount point in the second drop-down menu: local, my NIME hub, or a NIME business hub mount point. If a mount point is not connected, it appears gray in the menu and can't be selected. Select local and click browse to select a file in the local workspace. After selecting a file, the file path only shows the path within the local workspace. Third, select the relative to type, which accesses a file based on its location relative to the current workflow, or current workflow data area. If you select the current mount point as relative to path type, in this case, local, you can browse files in its local workspace. The convenient thing about the relative to type is that for this path, the mount point is updated automatically. So if you deploy the workflow to the NIME Business Hub, the node would execute without reconfiguring. If you select the current workflow, you can select any file under the current active mount point so that the file path starts from the location of this workflow. Moving to an upper folder level is indicated by two dots in the path. If you select the current workflow data area, you can browse files in a data folder inside the workflow. This folder is not visible in the Space Explorer. However, if you open the local workspace in the File Explorer, you can see that each workflow appears there as a folder. Furthermore, the workflow folder can contain a subfolder called Data. You can also create the folder if it doesn't exist. If you read a file from this workflow data area, the reader node will always execute in any location. When exported as a KNWF file, when deployed to a NIME Business Hub, when shared via the NIME Community Hub, and when moved within the local space, because the data folder always moves together with the workflow. The fourth path type is custom NIME URL. This path only consists of one part, a URL address for a path starting with the NIME protocol. Sometimes you want to read tables from multiple files and concatenate them into one table. You can do so with a single reader node, for example the Excel reader or CSV reader. For that, you select Files in Folder in the mode selection and the path to the folder here below. The dialog behind the Filter Option button lets you include and exclude files by their file extension, file folder name, and visibility. So far, we have only accessed files either on our local machine or in a connected mount point. However, the same reader nodes can read files in remote locations as well, if you provide the connection in the input. For example, let's access some files on Amazon S3. You use the Amazon Authentication and Amazon S3 connector nodes to create the connection. The connection is then provided to the reader node via its dynamic file system connection input port, which is hidden by default, but can be added via the plus button or by simply connecting the two nodes. Once connected, the configuration dialog only shows the connected file system in the Read From section. You can browse over the remote folders and files just as you did on the local file system. Once you have selected a file, the file path includes only the path within the remote location. Therefore, if you switch the input connection to another remote file system, for example to Google Cloud, the node will still execute if the path to the file remains the same. In this video, you'll learn how to read files in KNIME Analytics platform, how to configure the reader nodes with the different file path types, how to read multiple files with a single reader node, and finally, how to configure the path within remote file systems.